So how does this work in reality? Remember, we have social groups, our team versus the other team, so to say. And we want the lines between these groups to be clear and impassable. Anybody who passes from our in-group to the other one is seen as traitor and hated more than natural members of the out-group. The other way is also valid. If someone belonging to out-group comes in our group, we are not happy either. They show others that these borders are not impermeable, and because they managed to make it to our privileged group, we feel like they possess some extraordinary qualities, which can be used against us. They make us feel unconfident and insecure. They arouse anxiety for another reason as well. Because they are newcomers to our way of life, they keep questioning things that we have been taking for granted. Why do you do it this way? Does it make sense? Have you tried it differently? We end up having to explain and justify things that we have never thought about. Even if they do not ask questions and simply try to imitate our lifestyle and become like us, they cannot achieve this. They look like a caricature of us, and we see ourselves from their distorted mirror. And again, this upsets our comfort. As it is seen, there are plenty of reasons to watch the strangers suspiciously as a potential menace. This all wouldn't happen if they stayed where they belonged to and did not create ambiguous categories. So what are the solutions for these intruders that the societies in the world came up with? Because as George Simmel famously said, the stranger is not someone who comes today and goes tomorrow, but rather it is the person who comes today and stays tomorrow. Bauman suggests three ways of responding to the problem of strangers by the dominant group. 1. Sending those strangers to where they came from. This is especially for ethnically alien immigrants. 2. To commit a genocide. 3. Separate them geographically, spiritually, or both. The third option is the most commonly chosen one. That's why there are so many diasporas and ghettos in the world. People are forced to live in certain city parts, either by law, like it happened in South Africa, or because financial or social conditions force them. If a geographical separation is not practicable, spiritual separation grows importance. Social contacts with the strangers are avoided unless it's for business. Nothing emotional. I give the money, you give the product or service, and that's all.